top of my head if I have to. Yeah, no, I don't use that one.
No problem. It's super long, I know.
No, mine's long, but it's not necessarily as common.
Gotcha.
That's the only term I'm going to use.
Okay.
It's all good.
And then I'll go back and then I'll give you a thumbs up soon.
Well, good morning, everyone. It's a tremendous honor to be here today in Sage Creek in the heart of La Jambaudière. I'm Andrew Smith, the MLA for this area and the Minister of Municipal Relations. But before we get started, I'd like to acknowledge that we're gathered here on Treaty 1 territory and that Manitoba is located on the treaty territories and ancestral lands of the Anishinaabe, Ashinaniwak, Dakota Ayote, Dene Suliné, and the Hay-Thuwuk. We acknowledge Manitoba is located on the homeland of the Red River Métis. We acknowledge that Northern Manitoba includes lands that were and are ancestral lands of the Inuit, and respect the treaty and intent of treaties and treaty making, and remain committed to working in partnership with First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people in the spirit of truth, reconciliation, and collaboration. I'm pleased to be joined here today by Wayne Ewasko, the Minister of Education and Early Childhood Learning, James Teitsma, the Minister of Consumer Protection and Government Services, and Chipo Simunyola, my apologies, Ward 4 trustee for the Riel School Division. And I know we have a number of other folks here today. I believe Sandy Nimeth, the board chair of LRSD, is here today. I thought I saw her earlier. Christian Michalek, our superintendent and CEO of LRSD. Jeff Anderson, the assistant superintendent for LRSD. Brian Mays, the local counselor for St. Vital and for Winnipeg. We got representatives from Qualico, NTAG, HTFC, Bird Construction, and I believe Mark Poirier is here from the Sage Creek School. He's not here today, okay. And Lisa Elbrick, the vice principal of what they call Sage Creek, I believe neither are here today, okay. Thank you so much for being here today. It's a very exciting morning. I know we got a very exciting announcement ahead of us, so I will turn things over to our Minister of Education, the Honorable Wayne Ewasko.
Good morning, everyone, and it's a sheer pleasure to be here in Sage Creek on a nice, sunny, blue skies morning, and it's nice to see absolutely everyone attend for this morning's great, great announcement. I, too, want to extend thanks to my education partners and Municipal Councillor Brian May, also, who's here. Of course, Sandy Nemeth, who's the board chair for Louis Riel School Division. Christian Michalek, who is the superintendent, and of course Jeff Anderson as well. And we are also joined by some other trustees as well. So thank you all for joining us here this morning for this incredible, incredible announcement. I'd also like to echo what my good friend and colleague, MLA Andrew Smith and Minister of Municipal Relations. He has been a huge advocate for this for not only his whole constituency, but Sage Creek as well. So today's announcement, I know, is going to plode very well. And I see that we have some residents of Sage Creek have joined us for this great announcement today as well. So on behalf of Premier Heather Stephenson and all my colleagues, and of course, I'm joined by Minister Teitsma, who's gonna give us some behind the scenes details as to today's announcement. So I'm looking forward to that. I am absolutely thrilled to be here, to be able to be part of the announcement on the groundbreaking of the new Louis Riel School Division's K to 8 school right here in Sage Creek. It's great to see that dream is coming to reality. I know that Sage Creek has been the area residents and your MLA, Andrew Smith, has been advocating for this for quite some time, and it's great to see that it's coming to fruition. We know that childcare is a key component in any community infrastructure, and it supports families as they establish themselves in their communities, get their educations, and of course, enter the workforce. As part of our 23 new schools guarantee, our government is pleased to build these 2,000 plus additional childcare spaces. In partnership with the federal government, Manitoba has already made significant progress in adding childcare spaces. Over 3,000 spaces have already opened in the last 2 years, and there are thousands more to come. By adding more spaces to the childcare system, we will improve access to the high quality learning within our learning programs and our childcare sector. But that's not all that we are doing. We're also focusing on affordability. With over 31,000 children in facilities across Manitoba accessing $10 a day childcare, and thanks to the childcare subsidy, more than 4,000 families are paying as little as $2 a day. We've also invested in fairer wages to help attract and retain more childcare professionals. More seats are opening at our post-secondary institutions, and as well as seats within our school division stream as well. And we're providing tuition rebates to help more than about 650 individuals already to take advantage of the $5,000 per student per year of education in order to either upskill from a CCA training to ECE or ECE 2 to ECE 3s. We're doing more for Manitoba families, and there's even more good news to come. I want you all to stay tuned. I'm excited to be here in Sage Creek this morning with my colleagues and all the education partners. This is an exciting day for Sage Creek. Thank you very much for attending, and I look forward to, and I know you're all looking forward to, a little bit more details in regards to the K-8 school right here from Minister Teitsma. Thanks, Andrew.
Thank you very much, Minister Ewasko. I know this has been an incredibly exciting announcement here for Sage Creek, and I know the school that's going to be constructed right behind me is not only going to serve Sage Creek, it's going to serve Bonavista as well. I think that's incredibly important given the growth we've seen in this community. As this is a teamwork, this takes different levels of government. We know the province has worked very well with the city, and we've worked together. I want to say a special thank you to the Sage Creek Residents Association who are here today. I know that they've been incredible advocates for the community here in Sage Creek. We work very closely with them to make sure that projects like this are possible. Before I hand this over to Minister Teitsma, I do want to say we've got trustee Ryan Palmquist with us as well. My apologies, Ryan. I'm always used to you as Save Our Sane president, so wearing different hats today, but thank you again. I know that the work that the Louis Riel School Division has done has been incredible in this, and just so happy to see this coming to the community here in Lajamodi. It's very important. So with that, I will hand things over to Minister James Teitsma. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone, and just what a gorgeous day to be out here. And I know we're standing in front of an empty field, but what I want you to imagine is the possibilities and the future of what's going to happen in this very place. The education that's going to be provided to families in Sage Creek, to the children of families in Bonavista as well, is critically important to the future of our province. We want to ensure that our children receive high quality education and that they receive that in high quality schools. And that's what we're committed to building as a government. We initially committed to building 20 new schools across our province by the year 2029. That was in the last election. Since then, we've updated that. We've added 3 additional schools, bringing the total to 23. And we've compressed the timeline because of the incredible growth that communities like Sage Creek and Bonavista are having, and the incredible growth that we're seeing in communities across Manitoba as our economy thrives and as more and more people choose Manitoba as a place where they want to live. So three additional schools. We're also going to get them done 2 years sooner than originally promised. So the aim is to have all 23 schools open by 2027. That's critically important. And as part of that, as already highlighted by the Minister of Education, every single one of these new schools, not only will it have air conditioning, which I think we can be especially grateful for today, but it's going to have childcare spaces. Every single one of them is going to have childcare spaces, with over 2,000 of those childcare spaces being added to these new schools that are being built around our province. We pride ourselves as being a government that gets things done. We don't just simply promise that we're going to take action. We do take action, and you see that today. You see that this commitment to build the school that was made already a couple years ago, that's what we said we would do, and now we're making progress towards actually doing that. That's the kind of government that we are. And I should note, we're here in Riel School Division, and I have in front of me a list of projects. I won't list them all because they're going to take a while to get through, but I just want to be clear that that even some of these small projects are critically important, but they get done. And the repairs and maintenance that are needed on some of the older schools in our community are getting done. We've done a steam system replacement at Glenwood School. We've done significant upgrades at Collège Jean Sauvé, including heating and cooling system replacement and additions and renovations. Victor H.L. Wyatt School, Victor Major School, J.H. Brunn School, General Vanier, Marion School, St. George School, Nelson Mack, J.H. Brunn's Moore, Windsor Park Collegiate, Riel Arts and Tech, Nelson Mack, Frontenac. On and on it goes with major projects, roof replacements, science lab upgrades, the addition of hygiene rooms, you name it. Things that need to get done in these schools are getting done by our government. And I can assure the superintendent that I've already taken a sneak peek at next year's list of required projects and priorities for Riel School Division and then for some of the other school division. And I'm very excited to see the kinds of commitments we're going to be able to make as a government as we continue to take care of the capital infrastructure needs of our education system to ensure that our children have the spaces, have the places, have the environments where their teaching professionals, those who instruct them, can do their work and can do it productively and can do it in a way that's really going to help build our province for the decades to come. So I thank you very much. I'm very excited for this new school. It's, if I understand correctly from the trustees, this is intended to be a French immersion school and may in fact be one of the largest French immersion schools ever in the province of Manitoba. So very excited to see the construction get underway soon and very much excited to see what this can do for the communities of Sage Creek and Bonavista. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Minister Teitsma. I appreciate that, and I can attest as the father of a young child, knowing how important not only schools are, but daycare spaces are to our community. If you take a look around, anyone who knows Sage Creek, there's a tremendous number of young families not only living here, but moving in and wanting to move in. I think we're standing here with phase 10. I believe it's the final phase of Sage Creek's construction, and you know that this is going to be filled with young families who are going to be able to use this school and these childcare facilities. So this is so important. So I thank everyone for being here today to witness this very important announcement and know that this is going to help not only ease some of the pressures on the existing schools, but it's going to service the people who want to move here and invest in our community. So this is exciting. And with that, I'll hand things over to Mr. Simunyola.
Good morning, everyone. I know a lot of thanks have already been provided to all the partners to make this project successful. But I do want to also extend many thanks to the community here in Sage Creek. I am a resident of Sage Creek, so when we talk about all the creative ways the community and the administration have worked on to allow students to continue to learn, even though we had capacity at the other school, I want to thank the community. And as we continue to go through the process of this place being built, we do ask for more patience from you. But this is a win. It's a win for the community, it's a win for education, and it's a win for Manitoba. So I do want to thank the government for honoring their commitment, and I'm glad that they are looking at the projects that we would like to do in this area going forward. Because we have a lot, and our priority is to make sure we provide a safe place for all students to learn and our teachers to innovate. And this is no less. So thank you very much, and thank you to the community. And we're looking forward to having a structure stand behind me the next time we're having an occasion like this. Thank you.
Well, that concludes the formal part of the announcement. We will have a question and answer period with media, followed by a photo op. So if any media does have any questions, please go ahead.